Dear colleagues, I will, at the moment, according to order 429, dated 19 June, I'm deputy head on the working group on creation of vertically integrated systems, and we start working in ecology. I would like to give some brief information. You have an important work to do. I understand you have to collect different figures. We have to pass on to digital field. Digital transformation is inevitable. It is recognized as a fact. Now, the working group is quite representative. It comprises esteemed national medical research centers in Moscow, COEs, and different regions and experts. They work on creation of the digital counter under two federal projects, development of needs network, electronic digital counter, which also covers you, because subjects receive financing directly for completing basic information provided to all medical institutions, including oncology. Now we set up the unified digital counter that is not a single product. Vertically integrated system is called this way because it will bring together the best practices, the best products, and give a possibility of having transparent process of diagnostics and treatment. The patient will be in the system to the end of treatment or palliative assistance to ensure depreciation. You shouldn't call, but the system should help you. Should help the doctors to send to the next stage according to the procedure in your federal entity or federal order. Continuous monitoring of the condition of the personnel. You fill in a lot of forms, which is in the system of healthcare resources, equipment. The system would ensure the use clinical schemes and regimens of treatment in clinical practice, and the algorithms should be used for support of decision making. That seems like a space, but some elements like prompts to the doctors, then further analysis proceeds. So what will skip it? Curation levels are built, and I will show the functions of the system. Curation levels are constructed at each level from the center of outpatient oncological assistance and primary care to the federal ministry. Everything will be associated and seen in some role model. Each level will do its own work, and the information will be transferred between the levels due to the system. Many things, we don't need to have many papers to transfer information, of course, for a final decision making by the medical commission. We don't yet have the order on electronic document. Now we have been long waiting for that law. The first electronic documents probably will be adopted at the end of 2019. They will circulate in electronic form. I will tell you how it looks within what we create now. If you know, we have the unified state information system of healthcare. You can criticize it, but there are the main basic elements: Federal Register of Medical Workers, medical organizations, regulatory information, electronic medical medical history. For clinical work, that is not enough, as we understand, and clinicians work on the issues of transferring the information on the patient. All the information which you get in your medical centers and regional segments will automatically appear in the system. We have to pass on from the level of fixing the events in the register to the level of inputting the information online. That is not so easy, but to understand that this is our responsibility, we have good experience. So what will be the systems inside so that you would understand the detail level? Monitoring of patients. You have just heard that monitoring of patients We give some figures. Monitoring now is that in law there is a process of control of the status and passage of the patients through all the stages of providing medical or diagnostic aid. We have. I will pass on to the description. I'll skip this. But so what is monitoring patients? Information interaction is in place. It is interesting that since we spoke about the necessity of a departure and control of the patient, that will be done automatically on the basis of digitized clinical recommendations and protocols and regimens and schemes of treatment. Of course, you might be skeptical, but the doctor is always right. He might change the schemes. It will be seen and normal. But someone might make a change, and if then the general change is necessary, the professional community will take the decision. So management of the patient will be in an understandable, good interface. You have got your original systems, but we mean need access to that aggregated system of information. Your regions should change the approaches within their information systems. Methodological requirements will be issued according to the control point on the 30th of September 2019. Yesterday, we have placed on the portal of Ministry of Health the requirements to the medical information system, and then we'll detailize it for oncology. For this to be automated, we work on formalization and transferring to the digital form all the documents concerning clinical information. We started with diagnosis C50 with breast cancer that is well developed. That is a unique instrument. I can show it to you. Within the system, and the experts, not programmers, will build normative acts as and the roots of the patients, and will see what is the clinical recommendation, what association or professional community is preparing it, and the status of recommendation. It is done because you have now manual control, and control will be more understandable in the digital form. The passport or certificate of the service, that is the basic document, that term will be used. I think that the service passport, you get information, you give it to different sources, and the unified basis provides in program product. There will be a passport of the service. You will see your personnel and your equipment, but what was added furthermore is controlled. If everything is not true to reality, you'll have to bring to order these resources which you had. Besides, there is additional extension on profile things that are not regulated by norms. It is convenient because there will be an online comparison of departures from the requirement of the order 215N. What should we do in what amounts, and it will be seen quickly for control. Monitoring of the service, our operational elements, most of them will be available at SNVs and other supervisory bodies, and so that you, we might not request the information from you, but receive a trajectory of the activity of the doctor. All clinical cases of certain type will be in the system at any time. We agreed that we start major work in the working group. We have experts to prepare, to pass on to individual preparation of the plans for further training or retraining of experts, so that each doctor, depending on his specialty and the manipulation and medical procedures, so that we could prepare the route for the training that he needs. That will be only in 2021, so you shouldn't be afraid now. And the most important thing is that they're controlling national medical research centers, crossing the country. They'll find, they'll have the instrument without collecting the information that will is not an audit system, because that is a license activity control event. And on the basis of risk-oriented model, it is possible to control the federal entities and to talk locally with you having primary data and record all the necessary departures and recommendations. Scientific activity. As the final stage of the work, everything that is collected in big data should be available to professional community in depersonalized form. We observe law 152, federal law, but clinical schools want to get information for the analysis, development of the methods of research. They will be available. But there will be a process of access to the data that will be regulated. The depreciation will be seen in the system, and the system at each state. We demonstrated the prototype. We'll see the patient and the stage and where he moves. Brief, summary. We create a digital platform, but we don't create one product. We'll bring together everything that has been done and used in a unified platform. We'll develop the common rules and approaches you can work with your product, because there will be upgrading. Thus, we'll make a step forward. What are we doing now, briefly? We started in December, 29 December 2018, when the decision was taken that it was necessary. Then amendments were made to the provisions of the national research centers. They have to be have central systems that will control management of the patient, and the patient coming to any part of the country would have the entire history, and we could also see the patient. Then approval of the concept, it is currently being approved now. On the 19th of June, a commission and a working group was set up. The commission will approve the concept. We have developed technical requirements, and we have shown the prototype on the 18th. It was demonstrated. Then we prepared the pilot zone. We have selected three national medical research centers. That is Blakhina Radiology and a research institute named Afitro, four entities, the fourth for the Northwest. And those three asked to include the fourth one for cleanness of the experiment, that is Tomsk, Tulane Sverdlovsk region. After piloting in the subject that will be completed in August, it will be decided that in September, in the form that we have the first elements of the system, will circulate and involve other subjects. The order should be passed on implementation of the system at the end of 2019. This is a brief description of the work that has to be done. I will be ready to answer your questions afterwards. Thank you, Inna Viktorovna. Please do not leave. I have a short question. If in the federal entities, the oncological service implements electronic medical history, a digital code, should they agree with you on the misconduct? You can make whatever you like now, but there are requirements, and September is quite soon. All your concepts and movements has to be approved for that vertical integration. So then later, without any expenses, you'll become a part of the structure. You do not have to discuss it. You have to make it beautiful with minimum expenses. Should we send it to you or to the Department of Information Technologies of the Ministry of Health? That's a good question. Thank you. We have passed an order, and I understand that next week we'll send clarifications to the federal entities how to coordinate. Of course, it should be done. to the department or to Elena Dvorna Boyko, who is deputy minister and who controls the process and responsible for it, for this trend. Thank you.